Of a version of High Falls by the Allman Brothers. I'd never learned that song before, and I thought, well, I fancied that. So I went on to YouTube and thought there'd be a multitude of lessons in how to play that, but there were none. So yeah, here's my measly attempt at it. I hope it helps you out. I'm pretty unpracticed at it, so I did this as quick as I could. There'll be a backing track, the one I used on that. I put it on another video so you can have a play with it. Again, apologies for that. I did it. It's not the easiest song to sequence, is that the right word? So it's as rough as the, whatever. If it's of use to you, yeah, enjoy it. Okay, so the cool bit at the beginning, which is all spacey and probably flip to this thing. It's just cool. Okay, and then you just slide that one down. E stays in the room. Then back up. Yep, and then it goes to a D. Seven. Still sounding angry. Give us some scrubbing. Up to F. E major. And then up here to A. And put your little finger. Okay, and then it goes down to a G, but you. This is a G9 or something. You're emphasizing that D note. Then down to the F. Take off your first finger. And it's kind of like a B flat major 70 something. Again. Okay, that's the intro. And then you got the bass line comes in, and then we're up here. So, okay, and then you come down to this. You're on the B string. And again. Down on your first string. Repeats a couple times. That section, the second time round, comes into this. And then you do this. So you basically you're playing an A note.
A note.
Okay, on both strings. So you got your A string ringing out and an A note on the D string, but you just slide this D string around. Octave chords. recording the A string ringing out again with E note. Then the dreaded lick. Apologies for that. I haven't practiced it yet. I'm kind of a bit too lazy to be honest. Well, I had a go of it, but it's basically I do it slow. We got those cool chords, which I don't know what they are. I mean, that's kind of like an E minor 7 with an E up in the top there, but and it starts with the D string there. Okay, you take that shape, bring it down. So that's kind of like a C major 7. Yeah. That's the other shape again, and it's just flatten your little finger, and then that A chord. It goes like. Essentially it. You got the solo, then the solo is pretty tricky, and it's a good one to practice on, because I think every day you'll approach it differently. Like there's some days you just want to use A minor pentatonic all over it. Other times you want to, because it's basically C and A major. Sometimes you want to flatten notes, sometimes have fun with it. There's a few minutes of the jammy sort of stuff at the end of that backing track, so yeah. Well, it was pretty fun to work out. Enjoy, have fun.